The Radiation Medicine Program is the single provider of radiation therapy for patients living in the Ottawa region and surrounding communities. We provide this service from the general campus of the Ottawa Hospital and the Irving Greenberg Family Cancer Center at the Queensway Carleton Hospital site. The radiation therapy journey consists of three main phases. First, a treatment simulation appointment is scheduled within a few days following the decision to get radiation. After this simulation appointment is completed, a treatment plan is developed. That can take 0 to 10 days to finish. Once the treatment plan is ready, radiation appointments start shortly after. Because each plan is personalized, the number of treatments can vary between 1 and about 40. On-treatment support and monitoring is offered throughout the entire radiation therapy journey. The treatment simulation appointment is where we decide on the position that you will need to be in during your treatment, design treatment accessories such as a face mask to immobilize the body area to treat, obtain a CT scan of the body areas that need treatment, and sometimes mark your body with 1 to 5 small tattoos using permanent dots of ink the size of a freckle. We need this CT scan to design a treatment plan and calculate radiation doses specific to your body. We also need the tattoos and the markings to make sure your position can be reproduced every day on the treatment machine. To view these marks, the therapist may have to expose parts of your body during the positioning but will cover you up as soon as the positioning is over. It is very important that you are in a comfortable position throughout the procedure, so don't hesitate to speak up if the position isn't right for you. This appointment is booked at one of our 2 CT simulators at the General Campus or the IGFCC Campus. The appointment itself usually takes between 30 to 90 minutes, but plan to be in our department for about 2 hours. During the simulation phase, you will get to know the radiation booking clerk, who coordinates all appointments related to radiation, the radiation receptionist, who will verify your information, register you in the system, and provide instructions on how to prepare for the appointment, the radiation therapists, who provide the CT simulation procedure and provide education, and the radiation nurses, who are involved in preparing and monitoring some patients who may require a contrast or dye injected as part of the CT scan procedure. Once the simulation appointment is complete, treatment planning activities happen behind the scenes to outline the body areas to treat and organs to avoid, design a treatment plan and calculate radiation doses, confirm the number of treatments needed, which may be different from what your radiation oncologist initially told you, as he or she now has additional information to customize your treatment plan, and perform several independent checks to make sure the treatment team can deliver the radiation safely. All of this behind-the-scenes work is done to ensure the body area affected is getting the maximum radiation doses while we minimize the dose to the healthy surrounding tissues. This also gives us information to know how long to leave the radiation on and what angles the machine needs to take. This treatment plan can take a few hours to a few weeks for the team to complete, depending on the urgency and complexity involved. Working behind the scenes are radiation oncologists who identify where the radiation needs to be aimed, what organs should be avoided, and approve the radiation prescription as part of the plan review process. Radiation treatment planners who design a plan to focus the radiation beam using different angles and shielding patterns. And medical physicists who ensure the quality of the treatment plan and the safe operation of all radiation equipment. After the plan is verified, radiation treatment can begin. Radiation is used to kill cancer cells while avoiding as much normal tissue as possible. It can also be used to provide symptom or pain relief. Radiation treatment appointments involve reproducing the position chosen at the time of CT simulation, obtaining images to confirm the correct position, delivering the actual radiation, and providing counseling and education on how to manage symptoms. It's important for you to know that you won't feel anything when the radiation beam is on and won't be radioactive after the treatment is completed. The first treatment appointment is 30 to 45 minutes per body area treated. The following treatments are usually 15 to 30 minutes. We provide radiation treatment for the most common cancers on one of the six state-of-the-art Elekta linear accelerators at the General or the three at the IGFCC campus. For certain types of cancers or other diseases, more specialized treatment units only available at the General campus are needed. These include the CyberKnife, the Tomotherapy, the Brachytherapy, and the Orthovoltage units. During the treatment phase, you will get to know the radiation receptionist, who will verify your information, show you how to register in the system every day, provide instructions on how to prepare for the appointment, and assist you with booking changes. And the radiation therapists, who work in a team of 2 to 4 per machine to deliver the treatment and provide counseling and support on side effect management. During your treatment, you are typically scheduled for a weekly visit with a radiation oncologist to assess your symptoms, review any side effects from treatment, make adjustments to the treatment plan as needed, provide medical assistance as required, and refer you to other support services. These scheduled weekly visits are 10 to 15 minutes in length, but plan to be in the review clinic for about an hour. We have a review clinic in Radiation South and North at the General Campus and one at the IGFCC. Review visits and daily access to radiation nurses allow us to ensure you are tolerating the treatment, monitor and manage any side effects, and assist you with any questions or concerns. To support you during your treatment, you will meet your radiation oncologist or residents who are doctor specialists in training during their weekly morning or afternoon clinic. And radiation nurses, who are available to help you manage your symptoms and connect you with other healthcare professionals as needed. During treatment, the side effect most often reported by patients receiving radiation therapy is fatigue. This can be mild or moderate, and it's different for each patient. You may be able to continue all or a portion of your normal daily activities. Most of the side effects of radiation therapy are limited to the area where you receive radiation. For example, lung cancer patients may notice a skin irritation like a sunburn a few weeks after starting the treatment. A patient with cancer in the mouth may have trouble swallowing. Your radiation care team will discuss side effects that are more specific to the type of treatment you are receiving, and provide you with written instructions on how to manage them during your first and last week of treatment. While on treatment, it is important for you to complete the symptom assessment tool each week and review your symptoms with your radiation team, who will recommend ways to reduce the symptoms, prescribe medication, or suggest changes to your diet to help. Some side effects may last for several weeks after the final radiation treatment and leave you with permanent changes. It is important that you discuss and understand the risks and benefits of radiation therapy with your radiation oncologist so you can make an informed decision. Remember that each patient's disease and treatment plan is unique, and we take great pride in providing you with a personalized treatment plan that suits your specific needs.